my dear students. Today topic is lens. What is mean by lens? Lens is a transparent medium surface bounded by two refracting surface. We know that lens are of two types. First one is convex lens. Second one is concave lens. Convex lens is also known as converging lens. Concave lens is also known as diverging lens. Convex lens, we know that we are using like this. This is convex lens. Concave means like this we are drawing. This is concave lens. Then what is meant by this convex lens? Convex lens, it has two spherical surface. But middle is, this middle side, it is very thick. That at the edges, it is very thin. Concave lens, it is also two refracting surface. Actually, lens has a refracting surface. Maybe it is two spherical surface. Maybe one is, at least one spherical surface need. One must be plane, otherwise spherical. Okay? Then, here is also two spherical surface. Then, here is mid-side is thin. Compared to this, this mid-side it is thin. Edges, it will be thick. That's the difference between convex and concave lens. Then next is some terms used in lenses. First one is, already we are discussed in case of mirrors. First term is principal axis. We know that here is, in case of one line is, this is optical center. Optical center is denoted center. Center of the lens. That is, here also we will get one circle. This side also we can make a one circle. This center of this lens, that is we can say that optical center. The line passing through this optical center. We can say that it is principal axis. This side we will get one center of curvature C1. This side also we will get one center of curvature, that is C2. Then same way in case of this concave also. Next one is principal focus. Principal focus means, we know that this is convex lens. A ray of light is coming. Okay, we are using one object, candle or whatever it is. We are using this ray of light parallel to the principal axis. This is principal axis. This is parallel to the principal axis. After refraction, we know that it is ray of light coming from parallel to the principal axis. After refraction, it is focus on one point. That is principal focus. Then this distance between this optical center and focus, this is, we can say that this distance, that is focal length. Center of that lens, that is optical center. Next one, line passing through that center of curvature, optical center, that is this one, principal axis. Two center of curvatures are there. Then principal focus means ray of light parallel to the principal axis. After refraction, what happened? It coincide on one point. But in case of concave, then appears to meet on that one point. That is principal focus of concave lens. The next one is, that is focal length. That is focal length means distance between this focus and this optical center. That is, we can say that focal length. Then our aim is to, in this chapter, very important topic is image formed by convex lens. But first we have to discuss rules obtained for spherical lenses. Three rules are there. First one is, this is first rule. A ray of light parallel to the principal axis. After refraction, what happened? It is passing through the focus. How to draw this diagram? First we have to use one lens, center, that is optical center, to focus. This side is F1, this side it is F2. Same only here, optical center, F1, F2. Then ray of light, parallel to the principal axis. This is parallel to the principal axis. After refraction, passing through the focus. This is the first rule. Here also ray of light parallel to the principal axis. Then it will go like this, but appears to come to this focus in case of concave lens. This is first rule. Second rule, that is a ray of light passing through the focus. Then just opposite. Then what happened? After refraction, it principle axis. Here also same. It is coming from focus, then after refraction parallel to the principal axis. Then last rule, a ray of light passing through the optical center. Then in case of mirror, we know that it is retrace the path, but here no retrace, it is going straight like this. It is going here also same, a ray of light passing through the optical center, it goes straight. These are the three rules obtained for the spherical lenses. Three rules. Image formed by convex lens. Okay. We have six diagrams are there. First here, first case, second case, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Very, very important. Most of the times in CBSE, long answer type 1 question is asking from this side. Then first one. We know that we are already discussed in case of mirrors. Then first in case of lens, this is convex lens. First how to draw this diagram, this is convex lens, this is optical center. Here we can draw that, here is F, then here is, that is 2F. Okay, otherwise we can take F1, F2, otherwise we can take F and 2F. In some of the textbook they have given F1 and F2, some of the textbook they have given F and 2F. In any way you can take, no issue. Then first case, between F and O, object is at between F and O. Then here is object, this is our object, one arrow mark we have to make. This is object, if you are to represent, that is AB. Then first rule we can apply, then a ray of light parallel to the principal axis, parallel to the principal axis, after refraction what happened? It is passing through the focus. Passing through the focus, first focus. Then next one, third rule we can apply, a ray of light passing through the optical center. Then here we are not getting image, here this side we will get virtual image. Okay, here is, we will get image. We can represent A dash B dash. This is our first case. Then second one, object is at F. How to draw? Here we can take F, optical center. If you want, you are making, you can make 2F also, 2F. This is normal. Okay? Then next, at F. Then object position at F. Then this first rule, object AB parallel to the principal axis. Parallel to the principal axis, after refraction what happened? It is passing through the focus. Then third rule, a ray of light passing through the optical center. Then image where? At infinity. First case, this side behind this mirror, this side virtual we will get. But second case, we are getting at infinity. Next one, third case, between F and 2F. Then how to draw diagram? Same only, convex lens. Here is optical center, F, 2F, this side also F, 2F. Then object position between F and 2F. That means between F and 2F. Here we have to make diagram. Okay. Then ray of light parallel to the principal axis. Parallel to the principal axis. Then after refraction what happened? It is passing through the focus. The next one. Next rule is a ray of light passing through the optical center. Optical center. Then here we will get that is beyond 2F. Okay, beyond 2F we will get an image. Next one at 2F. Next one at 2F. At 2F. That means same only optical center F, 2F. Here also F, 2F. Then this is object. We can represent AB letter. Then parallel to the principal axis. What happened after refraction? Passing through the focus. This is first rule. Then next one, next rule is passing through the, third rule is passing through the optical center. It goes straight. Then image 2F, same only 2F. Next one, fourth, beyond 2F. Then object position is beyond 2F. A ray of light parallel to the principal axis. After refraction what happened? It is passing through the focus. Passing through the focus. This is our first rule. Then third rule we can apply, a ray of light passing through the optical center. Okay, optical center. Optical center, it goes straight. Then here where we will get image between F and 2F. Here object position is beyond 2F, but image position is between F and 2F. The next one, last one, at the infinity. Rays are coming from infinity. This one, downside also we can use. This is rays are coming from infinity. Many rays are coming from infinity. We are using 102. Then, first rule. After refraction, what happened? It coincide on focus. Here also, coincide on focus. That means, image position is at F. Then again, first case is, here we will get image. Second case, at infinity. Third case, beyond 2F. Fourth case, it is at 2F. Fifth case, it is between F and 2F. Last case, at F. Thank you. Tomorrow, we will discuss on the topic, image formed by concave lens.